Hey, what's up? This is Russ, also known as RK Slade, and we are gonna jump into a full game of Fortnite Battle Royale. Right here, I'm talking about the little area that I love to go to. I do have it sped up 4 times. There are no cuts in this video. It's the entire game, but I do speed up sections just to get through some of the long drawn out parts like this, for example. What we're doing here is we're gonna go head down towards the square cliff. You can see right there in front of me, I'm passing just over to the right of it. And that barn there is a really great spot. This ruined house here, and then this ruined house here. I always like to hit this little avenue. And all three of them have chests, so that's pretty good. Got a score here with an early scar, which is going to take us all the way to end game. So stay tuned for that exciting conclusion and see how that plays out. But we've got a chest here, so we're going to go ahead and loot it up and see what we can get. We're looking for shields, meds, of course, any kind of weapon. I do grab the other AR here, even though I don't need it, because I'm never sure if some folks are going to land back there at the dirt track and work their way back here. Usually when I start back at the squared off cliff, I will end up at this house as the third location that I loot. And I will usually then meet somebody if they're back there. But I have a little bit of time. The circle's right here on us. And so basically what we're going to do is go back to the second little spot that I like to come through. I'm actually working my way backwards. I usually start up the hill there and then hit this second, but just decided to try something a little different today. Got a good circle. The second chest here. Looking for shields, and we get a shield, which is great. So now we got full shield. We've got 3 minis, which is pretty awesome. I'm gonna go ahead and grab that pump. And the AR, just in case somebody else comes by here, we don't want to leave them with a decent gun. Now, one tip that I'll throw out there that I always do if I can, if I got a little extra time, is I loot these little brick piles because they get me started with, you know, 70, 80 brick. And that's always a good thing. I like to have about 300 brick before I get to end game. And so you'll see here, I'm just kind of checking everything out. Got our third chest of the loot avenue. This is not a very traveled avenue, but I like it because of that reason, and I like to not see a whole lot of people until end game. If I see folks early on, there's never a guarantee that I'll actually survive the encounter, so I'm of the opinion for my own gameplay that I enjoy playing a little bit more stealthy, doing things like this. So what I'm doing here is trying to figure out, I wonder if anybody's going to come up here. We are in circle. Maybe we'll catch some folks coming from that back track back there. Going to set a trap, and then we're also going to throw one of the minis down for bait. I'm still learning how to maneuver my way around the new inventory system. I really like it better than the old one, but I'm still a little clumsy with it. So there we go, we've got our little trap set, and we'll see if anybody happens to walk by it or into it. I've got a slurp, 2 minis, and a med kit, an epic scar, and a common gray pump. You can probably hear my kids in the background. They're having a good time playing some Lego Batman Beyond. Now, if you're wondering what I'm doing pausing here, kind of in the open, I'm pretty sure I saw somebody running down the road there past the RV, the bear, so I'm just kind of checking it out. You know, speaking of those early kills, I feel good. I got full shield, a couple of extras, so we're just going to put a couple of test shots over there. Don't see any movement, so then we're going to just move on into Retail Row. I know there's some folks over here. I've been hearing shots the whole time that I was looting. And so we're just double checking to make sure that guy's not just sitting over there on the edge. And we're going to work our way into retail and just see if anybody is anywhere near these strips here. And we did catch somebody running across the street there, so that's why I'm heading this way. I want to see if I can catch them. They went into the shops here. See, you can see them jumping around in there. So I don't ever run guns blazing into a building. It's just not my style. And so I always like to try and ambush people as they're coming out of a building or as they're running away. because they're usually not quite as aware. And if I get stuck in a building, there's just not a lot of escape possibilities for me. And again, I am more about stealth and kind of coming in and vulturing kills if I can. You can see this person is engaging. Unfortunately, they started running right as I started shooting, but I think they were a little confused because they didn't know where it was coming from, so they didn't skedaddle. But you can see here, I did speed it up a little bit, but I am just taking my time. Instead of just running out there really quick to grab the loot, I do take my time there. Want to make sure that nobody's in the area. Here again, we're grabbing some loot, almost a 200 brick. These resources there. You may be wondering why I left the Epic Bolt. And the reason is I'm just not great with a sniper in this game. And so, you know, there's two paths that I could follow. One is to pick it up and just practice and get better and better. And then the other one is to try to win. I really wanted to win today. In this video, I was actually working on Outlive Opponents challenges, and this was the fourth of four. And I just needed a few more just to get over 300 was the actual number. And at this point, we're well over that number, and so I'm going for the win now. And so for me, a win usually doesn't include a snipe, although I have a couple of snipe shots for the win. Some of my solo wins are snipes. I'm not terrible at it, I'm just not confident at it, so. For me, you know, if I'm in a base or if I'm sitting somewhere and I need to scope in on somebody, I can't move enough to not get sniped back myself. So typically when I get in a sniper battle, I take too long to scope in on somebody and I end up getting sniped. You can see there I left a shield. I did that on purpose. I was feeling okay with the slurp and the two minis. I wanted to have something that would actually give me health. And the minis are so fast, I prefer that over the full shield. Unless that's all I've got is minis and a full shield. But since I had the slurp, that would give me some health if I needed it. We're just taking our time out here, working the edge of the circle. Well, we're not quite on the edge of the circle, but you know what I mean. We're just kind of taking our time, not rushing into the middle of the circle for sure. We catch somebody coming in. Left to right over here. Possibly coming from Moisty Mire back there, or the prison maybe. We win this encounter, which gives us our second kill for the day. And by day, I mean this match. I'm not a high kill player, so two kills is probably about my average per game, especially if I make it to end game. It may be two or three. Here you can see my newbie building skills. But now we're over here at the prison. Got a new circle. I'm going to go ahead and just kind of get my wits about me. Go ahead and get that as close to full shield as possible. Now I wish I had that other shield. I probably could still go back and get it. I'm not exactly sure where it was on the map, but I decided to go ahead and work my way through the prison here carefully. I've got 495 bricks, so I'm okay there. That's going to be great for a base at the end. Over 400 wood. So here, you know, the prison's going to be out, so I'm just kind of meandering around, taking my time. I'm going to go ahead and break open a little passway through here. And so just kind of check the back there. I can see that, you know, we're probably going to be in no man's land here. We got Moisty Mire. Hardly anybody comes out to Moisty, so if anything, they've already moved on. Which is not 100% true all the time. I do see a base out here, so I need to be careful. Gotta go ahead and build up and try and grab some high ground. Of course, there's always that random weird building section that messes everything up. Again, I'm just having a hard time building today, wasting wood. I know somebody's potentially out there. I don't know they're out there for sure. I do hear some snipes, so we're going to push up a little bit to the edge and see if we can see them. We do get eyes on somebody out there. pretty far. And again, I don't have a bolt or a scoped or anything, so I'm just kind of trying to stay out of view. You can see them there, just kind of making their way across. So we don't really know what the circle's going to do next, so we're just going to build something to get us a little height. Still trying to figure out these controls sometimes. Not great at building, but getting better, that's for sure. So we got action down there to 195. Just got to be careful here too. We are in the top 10 at this point, so we're feeling good. Got almost full shield, couple minis, good gun, good med kit. And so here we go, we've got this guy. Gonna try and do a little long distance sniping with the SCAR. Get a few hits on him, and then he disappears behind the ridge. But I feel good about that. I always like when I can put some damage on some folks. Even if I don't get the kill, I know that they're gonna be hurting. And, you know, so hopefully they won't be such a threat to me. So we're just moving quickly over here. Obviously that sped up about 4 times, so I wish I could run that fast in the game. Maybe they'll one day add a potion that gives you super speed. But we're going to go ahead and try and get some high ground here. Alright, here's another person that has to rethink his life choices. Can't run out in the open like that. Alright, now we are 3 stories high. That was a good whistle. And so what we're going to do now is I do have a trap, so I want to edit up this wall and make a little door and then jump down. And go ahead and put this trap on the back side just in case somebody decides to be a little sneaky and run around my base. I'll go ahead and take out the ramp. And see if that, see if anybody's unaware enough to just walk up next to it. So that's 2 traps we set in this game. So far, no little fishies have come in and taken the bait, but we're sitting pretty here in the top 5. Circle's moving in. We're almost dead center circle, which is, you know, not what I try to do all the time, but put a few hits on this guy, and I'm not going to continue to barrage him with gunfire because I only have 24 rounds at this point. I need a kill. I need to kill somebody who's got some ammo for me. So, trying to play real cautiously here. That guy's set up really nicely over there across the way. Still in the top 5 here. He's going to say hello to me. I'm going to try to repair that. Doesn't work. He's just letting it rip. Which is, you know, I mean, it's a good strategy if you've got a lot of ammo. I don't have any ammo, but what it does is it flushes me out, puts me right in the crosshairs of this person right here. Fortunately, my terrible accuracy there, I was still able to get the kill. Grab a little bit of loot and then decide I need to get somewhere a little bit safer out of sight. And so we're going to go ahead and use our mini shields to get to 50. Go ahead and get to full health with a med kit. And we're going to finish it off with a full shield. And so that worked out good. Had I used the full shield first, I wouldn't have been able to use the mini. So that was pretty sweet. I do pick up about 70 more rounds for my AR, so that's good. Now we're going to let those folks just engage each other. We're in the top 4 now, so there's 3 other people. I see a little movement down here in the cave. Hello, little mousy. So, good little jump there. We did take some damage. Fortunately, it wasn't all of our shield. We still got about 40 shield points left. We're stuck down here in the cave. We are left with only two people, so they took out somebody else right below their base, which was kind of a bad idea to rush that base. So I'm over here trying to figure out a way to build. They can obviously see me. Whew, almost got sniped there. Decide to go ahead and get on out of here. I'm going to try the other side. It's got a little bit more cover there. They know they've got me kind of pinned down here. This is not looking good for me here. Top two, they're going for that sky tall base. If I had something explosive, that would be sweet. I didn't use the scoped AR. I probably should have pulled that out and just, you know, rained down on them. But I was trying to be super cautious here. I was trying to catch them. Trying to catch them on a fall. You know, I know that their base is taller than three stories, so if I can just get them to fall down, then I have a chance. See how high their base is? I'm sure they know that too, which is why they're defending fiercely. Just got pegged for 33 shield damage. And now we decide to go for it. Let's do it, boys. Let's push up a little bit. They're still up high. They're wrecking us. Switching guns is not my forte. Let's go push in. Here we go. Let's do it. Boom. Victory Royal. Let's see that again. Fall damage for the win. Got one hit on them there. There's no way you can survive that. So when you build bases, I don't know why anybody wants to build any base that's taller than three stories high, but some people still do. I only always go three stories high for that very reason. We got the win, so proud. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, hit that like button. Appreciate all the subscribes. And my name is Russ, also known as RK Slade, and I will see you in the next video.